misplaced by intuition. That digit counters fall. That deaf, dumb, and blind kid. Jack plays mean pinball.
Whoa, whoa, whoa. How about we not get copyright claimed today? Just do the intro. What is going on, YouTube? Today is another review of an Apple Arcade game. But before we get into that, this is probably one of the only chances that I will have to talk about pinball games. Now, I've played a ton of pinball games. I love pinball games, both in real life and in video game format. I got started with the real life pinball machines, and on my first job, they was actually in the break room or break restaurant type area, I guess you can call it. Anyway, there was a pool table and a pinball machine. We'll talk about the pool table some other time, but the pinball machine there was the Back to the Future pinball machine, which already was my favorite movie. So to get the chance to play it on a daily basis in pinball form was fun. Now, growing up, I played a bunch of pinball games, and I never really realized that there was like a theme to it or, you know, a way to actually beat the game with most of them. Not all of them, but the vast majority. Anyway, this was one of those first pinball games that I had a chance to play, learn, and actually try and beat. Don't think I actually beat it, but it was the start of my love for pinball games. Even earlier than that, I played games like the Windows pinball game. I think it was called 3D Space Cadet. I played that. Even earlier than that, there was a game on the NES called High Speed. And it was based off of a Williams table. I know that much. And I know it had some voice work in it, which was kind of digitized and goofy sounding for the NES. I believe it was an early NES game. But anyway, those were like some early ones that I remembered that I really liked. When I was younger, I had this LCD pinball game called Pinball Wizard. And it had voice too. I think it was called the Talking Pinball Wizard, something like that. Anyway, whenever you started, it would make this line. It would say, "Welcome to the Pinball Wizard." And since it was an LCD game, you know, all of the graphics were in place. You could actually cheat in that game because the timing was so forgiving that if you knew what to do, you could do the same motion over and over and over again and just completely rack up points. You could play endlessly for as long as you wanted to, as long as you knew the timing, which was so forgiving in that. I mean, you can't really do a lot of physics with an LCD game. Moving on from that, I don't think I played a whole lot of pinball games until I got tablets. And I remember when I had an Android tablet, one of the games that I loved to play was the Pinball FX series, which was like a whole bunch of pinball games in one. You pretty much had to buy each one, but there were a ton of different themes. I remember the Fantastic Four one and the, I believe it's the Marvel Avengers one. Both of them were real nice tables. The Fantastic Four table was real cool looking. The Avengers table was real nice. Good physics. And you had a chance to, they had endings to them, even though you keep playing, but there were goals and stuff to do. And they had achievements. I remember getting the achievements for both of those tables, all of them, 100%. High score, everything. Just real nice stuff. And I really can't think of too many other pinball games that I played after the Pinball FX series. Technically, I still have them, even though I don't have an Android tablet anymore. So I could always find a way to play them again or buy the Apple iTunes App Store version. Find the name. App Store version of them. But I'm probably not going to do that, because I found a game right now that I'm enjoying from Apple Arcade, and let's go ahead and talk about it now. So the name of this game is The Pinball Wizard. Basically, you have to climb a tower in order to restore this artifact to its proper position. Now, to do that, you have to climb floor by floor, and each floor is its own mini pinball stage. Each level works a little differently, but they all pretty much have the same idea, and that's to find the key, whether it's hidden in the stage or among one of the enemies that you defeat by slamming into them. If you haven't already noticed, instead of a ball, you actually play as the apprentice, the hero of the game, whose job it is to make it to the top of the tower. Once you find the key, you move up to the next level. Now, you do have to be careful because you have a life bar, and if you fall between the flippers, you lose health. You lose too much health, and it's game over. But don't worry, if you make it far enough, you don't have to start at the bottom of the tower. Also, the XP that you learn while playing unlocks special moves, so the next time you play, you can actually do more. The fun really comes after you start leveling up and getting these extra abilities like the dash and the multi-ball-like orb that allows you to attack enemies from afar, as well as change your trajectory. These abilities use energy, which can be replenished through potions and also barrels that you find on each level. You can really have fun going through the game at your own pace, unlocking abilities and spending experience to upgrade them, knowing that there's no paywall and there's no seriously hard grind in order to get these things. Most of them just come your way through regular play. The physics are very well done in this game, so if you're familiar with regular pinball and how you should use and navigate the ball, then all those strategies pretty much work here. The only time you might get a little frustrated is when some of the enemies that you can't hit all of the time, because sometimes they're invincible and other times they hurt you. That window is not always so clear, and sometimes you'll think that you're able to attack them when really they go into the invincible state and you lose health. So you just have to be extra careful. A lot extra careful. Anyway, other than that, there's not too much more to say. It's a very good game. It's definitely a play. And if you like pinball, you're going to enjoy it. Especially if you like the combination of a pinball and a dungeon crawler, which is what this game is being advertised as being. I give it a thumbs up, A plus, another one, and let's see what we can find next time. So until then, signing out.